It's Pete from Cheap Homesteading, and we're in the Sugar Shack today, and this is the second boil. After Good Friday service, we came back and we decided to boil just as much as we could anyways, just so it wouldn't be a long, long day on Saturday. And so we invited some friends over and we had a good time, and then we let the fire go down a little bit so then we can go in. So I went out this morning and threw some wood on it, and it started up. There's enough coals, so that makes it a good day in my book. And the hardest part is getting it started. Once it's started, you just keep throwing logs in there. There's no issue. So we're gonna get boiling the rest of the sap. The fire is just starting to go farther down the pan. So that should take a little bit, but it'll get rolling for sure. Once it is warm, there is no issue getting draft up the chimney, so sometimes it's a little bit too much. Yeah, the chimney is not too warm yet, but it's gonna go. I don't think I'm far from the finishing process. It's getting a good color. It's still way too much water though. There's only about an inch in this pan, and about 2 inches in this pan. So really, I really can't be that crazy far off, so it's not gonna be a long day for sure. Got the coffee?
Got the coffee.
We are good. So there we go, we're still boiling, and it's looking a lot more like maple syrup. Still coming. So we are down to one pan. So this is how I do a shutdown of my evaporator. When this pan gets empty, I drain it, and then I set it off the fire so it can cool, so I don't burn it. And then I try to keep it in the big pan as long as I can. And at that moment, I gotta try to get my finishing pan up to temperature, because that is where the rest of the boiling will happen. So as I shut this thing down, I'll show you. So you remove the last pan as the sap runs out of it so you don't wreck your pan. And it doesn't seem to matter so much that the smoke's coming out the back. My building's pretty open anyway, so there's no issue there. So then I run the front pan and my finishing pan. But you want to try to keep it in your biggest pan possible for as long as you can, because it'll evaporate much quicker. If you put it into your finishing pan too early, it takes forever. The first sign that it's getting a little thicker is it starts to hold a drip. It's less like water. We're down to one pan, so we're gonna check the specific gravity, and if it's ready, we'll draw it off. So you fill up the tube, and it's a hydrometer, so it tells the specific gravity of the maple syrup. So when it's ready, it will float at about 58, 59, and then you know it's done. But it's quite a piece yet to go. I throw snow on the fire just to cool it down quickly, so it doesn't keep boiling the maple syrup after it's ready.